Good morning or good afternoon, Augusto Mastro Pasqua presenting the paper number 29 entitled The Laser Tube Technology, a new automation procedure in end preparation of circular hollow section intersection welded by partial joint penetration. The work was conducted and assembled in cooperation with my colleague Massimo Majewski from UAB University of Venice and Claudio Duarte from ARUP Amsterdam. The presentation is split over these six points. Firstly, we have a look at the interesting case study, which is the Swan River Pedestrian Bridge, Australia. Second point, we move to the throat size problem in the Australian Standard 4100 and the associated tubular design guide. And then we have a look at the polar dihedral distribution in the tubular intersection, especially for circular tubes, to move them to the laser tube cutting technology and finally converge to the experimental phase that was here described and the associated numerical analysis developed for to investigate the stress distribution in the throat plane. The Swan River Pedestrian Bridge is this strange and amazing bridge that was recently realized in Perth, Australia. It is characterized by a really curious oval shape, but also from a multi-intersection of tubes with several overlapping to reproduce, to create the truss effect over this is the section, the structural section. This bridge lead the designer to face one more time what is called as the problem of the throat size in dimensioning and verification of the welding. The problem is some way the same that is can be met when we analyze the same structure with the Eurocode or the American standard. And finally, it end up to a technological, let's say, a technological issue for the designer, which would lead the designer to apply if the overstrength criteria for the welding or the dimensioning of the weld is applied. Then we can see in this slide that according to the Australian standard or according to the European code or even according to the American standard, the required throat of the size of the throat is in many cases is approximate to the same thickness of the brace or in most of the case even greater than the wall to be welded. The same Australian standard, however, in at least two points, let's say promote give incentives to the designer and to the fabricator to move to a different kind of welding solution. In particular, we are talking about partial joint penetration or compound joint penetration, which is a combination of continuous combination between fillet weld and partial joint penetration. However, the same recommendation are visible in the recent international standard 14.346 in the Annex B. Every time the thickness of the wall is greater than 8 mm. This kind of issue is known as a throat size problem, or sometimes is referred to as a reduction of fillet weld problem. It was studied by several authors and it is still studied. Mainly it is, let's say, attacked by with three approaches. The first is an introduction of high strength grades like as an example, the series S420 or S460 or S690, quoted in the Eurocode 3 part 1.11.12, or by technological optimization of the welding process, which is actually an insight in metallurgical sense in the welding, or finally by taking care of the geometry of the weld, and this means the size and the spatial position of the weld. Anyway, the throat side problem still leads to a remarkable lack of applicability in terms of metallurgical and technological realization of fillet weld, particular in structural application, and especially when the overstrength criteria will be applied by the designer. To exacerbate the problem, let's add now the issue related to the continuous variability of the dihedral angle in the tubular intersection. And so what we are now talking about is a leap between a fillet weld solution and a partial joint penetration solution, that in some sense could be meant as a leap from a continuous dihedral variability of the throat plane to a continuous dihedral variability of the beveling plane. So we are actually moving from a manual process to an automatic numerical control process. The laser tube technology nowadays will allow for something that is really interesting. The sample that was realized is visible in this slide, and is interesting to see the video that was taken during the realization of one of the five samples realized. In particular, we can observe the first laser application with the perfect right position of the laser head, which is followed in a few seconds by the second step that required the continuous inclination of the laser head along the saddle shape of the tubes. Finally, the completion of the realization can take something like 60 seconds, 70, 75 seconds, which is something really, really important in terms of efficiency, time, and cost efficiency. What we have seen in the previous. So actually, in moving between the crown point where the angle zero is and the saddle point where the 90 degrees is, we can observe the variability of the beta 1 angle, which is the beveled angle realized on the brace, the wall brace to be welded. From geometrical point of view, what happens in terms of dihedral distribution is visible by three trajectories. In trajectory 0-1, we can keep under control the external dihedral angle C. With trajectory 0-2, we can control instead the variability of the beta 1 angle, which is the actual preparation of the metal, whereas in with the trajectory 0-3 is possible to observe the stability of the final the target of the application, which is the phi beta angle that lead in this case to a perfect certification of welding. In terms of throat distribution, instead, it is interesting to observe the variability of the throat size along the welding path, whereas for partial joint penetration, a perfect stability of the throat size 5 mm is always assured. This clearly is due to the independence of the throat size from the diatron angle, only for partial jaw penetration. So the numerical analysis that was conducted alongside this finally highlighted how approaching to the saddle point 90 degree, a sensible reduction of the Z stress distribution. Z is the direction of the load transmission, so is the direction of the brace member actually, of 70% less was obtained, which is a sensible reduction. Instead, if we project the stress on the throat plane, then 35% is still was still gained in the saddle point. In terms of ultimate strength, and then for the fillet weld solution, the elastic the onset of the post elastic phase was conventionally set to 500 kN, whereas for the post elastic of the partial joint penetration in the bottom, we can see the beginning of the post elastic phase is set can be set to 700 kN, so we are talking about 40% more performance in this way. So as conclusion, the throat side problem for circular arm of section intersection still represent a code practical issue in the design and certification of tubular joints, especially because it's preventing in most of the case the full load capacity transmission. The Australian code AS4100 in this sense promotes the use of and different kind of preparation, partial joint or compound joint preparation. This accordingly to the last international standard 14346. New technological possibility are nowadays applicable thanks to the recent six-axis laser tube cutting machine. We have seen an example with three main advantages. The first, high performance in terms of time consuming and cost effectiveness. The second, removal of the geometrical uncertainties concerning the throat size and this plane spatial distribution. And finally, a qualitative improvement in the stress distribution and the ultimate strength of the connection. However, a more intensive and experimental campaign program aimed to investigate the ultimate strength and the collapse modality could be enacted, comparing the fillet weld solution and the partial joint penetration solution as an example, measuring the ultimate strength of the connection. Thank you for your attention and good continuation of this conference.